I think because, you know, I believe you are who you are. There is this argument, nature versus nurture. There may be some truth to that, but I know people from brilliant lives who are just useless and people from horrible lives that have become, you know, you get paths to choose in life. And I think my mum left when I was 9. My dad went to prison when I was 13. I was on the streets as a teenager. And I had an opportunity where I could either go down the criminal path, which I do sometimes wonder might have been easier. Never a good deed goes unpunished. But I decided to go down the right path away from what my dad did. And I started my first business because I was sitting, my dad was in prison and I went up to visit him and I was sitting in a dentist and I opened a magazine and you know you get the secondhand magazines and I saw these stick-on bras and I thought, oh my God, that's fantastic. Because anyone out there with big boobs knows it's a pain when you're trying to wear a low-back dress with the straps. So you stick these things on and hoist your boobs together in a perfect position. And then I went selling them door to door.
What were they called?
Jolly Bust.
Jolly
so
Bust.
So I go around, because my dad had taught me his entrepreneurial ways, but I stayed on the right side of the law, I did a P.O. box where it meant you could get a posh address where they send you things. And so they would send them and I would take them around selling them from America. And we got a few complaints because some women had hairy nipples. Surprisingly. So when they would stick the things on and pull them off, they would complain. But I said it's a two-in-one. You get a free wax and you stick your boobs together. So why are you complaining? So it became really successful. And then I sold that as a multi-level marketing franchise thing. And then I was a millionaire by the time I was 19. And then my mum died suddenly at 47. She'd lost a leg at the same age. They reattached it. Another long story. And I just went, you know what, money doesn't mean anything unless you're going to make a difference with it. So right. That's when I got involved in the war in the former Yugoslavia in the landmines.